Hi there. So we've been receiving a bunch of questions in regard to the stimulus check and the CARES Act, when you should be receiving a check, and if you should be receiving a check. So here's a quick rundown on what you can expect. If you file single and you have earnings of $99,000 or less, if you file head of household and have earnings of $146,500 or less, or if you file jointly and your combined earnings are $198,000 or less, you should be receiving a check from the federal government. Now, the amount of check that you receive will vary, and that's dependent on your earnings. For those that file single and for those that file head of household, the maximum amount of check you will receive is $1,200. Should you be filing jointly, the maximum would be $2,400 or $1,200 each. For each segment we have here, so if we file single, if you earn $75,000 or less, you will receive the maximum check. If you file head of household and you have earnings of $112,000 or less, you will receive the maximum. And if you file jointly and your combined earnings are $150,000 or less, you will receive the maximum check from the federal government. There has been some questions on do you have to do anything? And the answer to that is no. And if you file your tax return on a direct deposit, you will be receiving that amount directly into your bank account. If you do not, we think that you'll be receiving a check in the mail. So if you could at this time and file and put a direct deposit on file, you probably would receive your payment a little bit quicker. One last thing to note here is that for each child that you have under the age of 17, you will receive a $500 check as well for each one. And on the bottom right here, we have a little example. There is depreciation, so should you earn more than what the minimum is stated here, it will be depreciated about 5%. So the example we have is if you earn $80,000 and you file single, that's $5,000 above what the minimum is here. So we would multiply that by 5%, giving us the number of $250. We would subtract that from the maximum, which is $1,200, giving us a total of $950, which you should be receiving from the federal government.